Well, what say you?
You're not gonna like it.
Now, see here. I am graced with the Abilene family's robust constitution.
Two pennies robbing the Bank of England.
The governor of the bank. I think I might need to sit down.
There's no time for that. Bastard's probably deep in the vault by now.
However you get in, I don't want to know.
Of course. But do you know how I can get in?
The bank is designed to protect England's gold reserves. A fortress, guarded under lock and key. There is the bank manager, Mr. Osborne. Only he is allowed free access to the vault. You can spot him near the entrance. And, oh yes, one man keeps a close watch on the vault door. He watches it like a hawk. If he sees you, he's sure to seal it. The guard captain, Gus Howard, knows Twopenny well. He is in on this, I'm certain. Mr. Fry, please use discretion. The only way to implicate Twopenny is to catch him in the act. Do not jeopardize him. No big displays. This is the Bank of England. If you encounter any trouble, I'll be in the atrium. In disguise.
Twopenny won't be leaving that vault.
Thank you.
Where is Tupini?
Please! I have a family. He's in the vault ogling his priceless paintings.
Please, don't harm me. I'll assist you. What would you have me do?
I rather fancy a private tour of the vault.
I'm going to gut you like a fish.
Oh, fancy. Fitting for Tupini's tomb.
Right this way, sir. The records are stored in here.
Hurry now. You will get your cut as promised.
We'll be rich.
Mr. Starek will be pleased with our work tonight. Your clumsiness.
Sorry, sir.
We'll be rich.
We will count everything later. We should be nearly finished by now.
It's a hard life.
You've stolen your last shilling from the people of London.
Those animals squander their savings. We are the experts in investment. Nothing would be built or improved. Nothing would rise above the muck without our hand guiding. No creating the future. They benefit as much as their work.
It is their city, not yours.
Without our investments, there would be no city.
For the path of the dead.
Thank you.
Arrest them all for robbing the people of England. The Bank of England is closed until further notice.
Currency, a laughing stock. Inflation out of control, Twopenny brutally murdered.
And yet Parliament does nothing.
The bill will be defeated, sir. That buffooned Disraeli shall be taken care of. It has been arranged, upon my honor.
Your honor carries little weight.
How dare you, sir!
The poor people of this city have suffered enough. Today I granted a significant rise to my staff in order to counter inflation.
What?
I would supply all of London if I could. Meanwhile, you sit in your club and wax poetic with promises your honor cannot pay. Your family's fortune, however. I wonder what they would offer to keep your record out of the newspapers. About the same as Disraeli would offer for your balls, I'd wager. But let's be generous. Why limit ourselves to one or the other when we can have it all? What say you, sir? Shall I come collect? No more dallying. The halls of Parliament must be free to govern. Again. Understood? You may see yourself out.
Dear Mr. Starrick, men hired. Strike tomorrow. Disraeli's death will stall Corrupt Practices Act indefinitely. Gladstone will be far more pliable. May the father, etc., etc., be. So Starrick's got his finger in politics, has he? I need to enter the Sinopian Club and find out who B is.
Tread delicately around Parliament.
As if I don't usually.
Your indiscretion at the Bank of England caused British currency to nearly collapse.
Nearly is the operative word. Speaking of collapses, what of the key you found that unlocks very little?
Henry took it for research. I am confident that the vault is ours.
Nearly ours, Evie.